This chapter one reviews the process of structuring an equity-linked, principal-protected note via the purchase of a fixed-rate bond and call option. We begin by assuming that an investor has given you $100 and has asked you to provide her with a vehicle for investing in Microsoft shares for a 3-year time horizon. Recognizing, however, that Microsoft shares are volatile and could expose much of her investment to a loss, the investor also asks that your bank guarantee the return of her principal in 3 years' time. Finally, the investor specifies that she would like to receive a coupon paid annually equal to 1% of her principal. You can probably recognize right away that to provide the guaranteed coupon of 1% and the principal at maturity, you will need to invest a large portion of the investor's money in some sort of fixed income security. You therefore call up your funding desk and ask them how much it would cost to purchase a 3-year bullet bond with a 1% coupon bearing the credit risk of your institution. Worksheet bond shows the next few calculations. We assume for this exercise that the US Treasury yield curve is flat at 5.5% and that your bank's credit spread over the US Treasury curve is 75 basis points for all maturities. This means in turn that the appropriate discount rate to apply to cash flows carrying your bank's credit risk is 6.25%. For the sake of simplicity, we are assuming that all payments are made annually. Excel permits us to calculate the present value of a 3-year bond carrying a 1% coupon issued by your bank, with the result appearing in cell E15. You can look up the formula behind this cell E15 by clicking on it, then clicking insert function, whereupon the PV function opens in front of you. The PV function requires you to input, as you can see, 100 for FV, the face value of the bond, C11 times 100 for PMT, which is the coupon relative to the stated face value, C10 for NPER, which is the number of periods, and perhaps most importantly, C8 for rate, since this is the appropriate discount rate as explained above. Many people are tempted to input C11, which is the coupon, next to rate, since they associate the word rate with the concept of a coupon. But Excel uses the word rate to denote the discount rate for the bond's cash flows. It is next to PMT, we remind you, that you input the actual coupons. The present value, i.e. the price of the bond you need, turns out to be 86.03, leaving you with $13.97 to invest in something else. This something else that you are looking for can be either a direct investment in Microsoft shares or an investment in call options on Microsoft, since either of these alternatives would give you upside exposure to Microsoft shares. Pros and cons of each are discussed a little later, but for now, we assume you go ahead and invest in call options. Please click at this point on the next worksheet labeled Option Prices. A European call will be sufficient for your purpose, since the investor is concerned only with the final price of Microsoft shares at the end of the 3-year time period. The worksheet models European calls and puts using the Black-Scholes pricing model. Pricing a call option on shares requires you to input the share's spot price, its volatility, the strike of the option, the option's maturity or tenor, the risk-free interest rate, and the dividend yield of the stock, which happens to be zero in this instance. Note that the risk-free interest rate has been converted from 5.5%, which was an annually compounded rate, to 5.35%, which is the continuously compounded equivalent rate required under the Black-Scholes model. The process of converting an annual rate into one that is continuously compounded is discussed in some of our other modules. You will quickly see a pattern here that should be familiar. The higher the strike of the call option, the lower the price of the call, since the probability of a gain for the buyer becomes smaller the more we increase the strike. The opposite, of course, is true for put options. We will not be needing the put option prices during this discussion, but you will use them to answer some of the quiz questions at the end. Remembering that you have only $13.97 to invest, you choose the strike 60 call option, which costs $13.15, and leaves you with 82 cents as your profit margin. In effect, you would be offering the investor a package, which we will henceforth refer to as the ELN for equity-linked note, whose price is 100, but whose fair value on its issue date is in fact only 99.18. Going forward, we will refer to the 1% bond as the bond and the strike 60 call option as the option. The term sheet for the ELN that you offer your customer would look as follows. The formula for the redemption amount shows the receipt of the guaranteed $100 from the maturity of the bond on that day, plus the contingent payment under the option, which would be the excess, if any, of the final stock price over $60. This completes chapter 1.